Now I am going to discuss the continuous part, the word between was and part 3, 1900 to 1950 in this way. Yesterday I discussed about causes for Second World War. So now we are going to discuss the important topic, consequences of the world wars. It means what are the main cause for World War I and what is the main cause for World War II? Two things we will discuss right now. First of all, enormous human cost. After end of the World War, we concluded and we discussed what loss was happened. Enormous human loss was happened. What that is? In the First World War, 10 million of common people were died. And in Second World War, 20 to 25 civilians are died. And afterwards, USA was dropped the two nuclear bombs in Hiroshima and Nagasaki. That effects are lost, and still some of the people is suffering with leukemia and cancer due to nuclear weapons. So lot of loss, human loss. We can't fill up such human loss. So that is enormous human loss was happened. And next one, democratic principles asserted. It means here several empires was completely ruined. For example, Austro-Hungary Empire is completely ruined, and Russian Empire is completely ruined. Ottoman Empire, that is also completely ruined. In that place, Ottoman Empire, in this place, Turkey democratic state was happened. And another one is Austria Empire was completely ruined. Then Austria separate state was established, and Russia socialist state was established, and Tsar Empire was completely collapsed in Russia. So that was new democratic principles was asserted, new states was born here. So that's why we say democratic principles. Some nations got independence, and some nations, new nations are born here. So that is the second principle. And third one, change in balance of power. Change in balance of power means here two groups, and groupism also changed. In the first group, in the First World War, one group is there, the Central Powers, and afterwards the Triple Entente and the Triple Alliance is there. Both the two groups are there. Suppose the Central Powers. In that Central Powers, Italy was middle dropped, and in Triple Entente, Russia was middle dropped, and groupism also changed. New independent nations also joined with these groups. That is, new balance powers was started. And Japan is the number one power in Asia. Imperial power in Asia. And it is a strong military base. And Russia. And later, next one is new international organization. New international organizations means after end of the First World War, League of Nations was established. After end of the Second World War, in October 1945, United Nations Organization, that is UNO, was established. UNO and nearly six organs are there, and sub-organs are there, specialized agencies are there. For example, UNESCO and UNICEF and WHO, ILO, like this number of institutions are established under control of the UNO, and those institutions are working, and it is the main aim to the progress of all world citizens. And new international organizations give a good status for poor nations, and economically supported these institutions. And later enfranchisement of women. Enfranchisement of women means here, first of all, in the textbooks point of view, Britain women got right to vote in 1918 by fighting off men. They secured political rights as well as their financial powers in 1918. That is, woman suffragist movement was also happened in 1914. So these are all important things we discussed in consequences of world wars.
after end of the world war, what the thing was happened, that is the main thing. And now I will ask some questions right now here. What are the two groups, can you say, participated in world war? Central powers and triple entente. Like that, number of questions you also form and later discuss in coming lesson. Before starting the lesson, I will ask number of questions. You prepare thoroughly. When I will start the lesson, say next lesson, then I will ask a number of questions. You thoroughly prepare this one. Okay, students?